and welcome to Honest Amateur Celebration and Giveaway Hop. We are crafters coming together to celebrate the growth of Min's channel and her channel anniversary. We've got some wonderfully amazing sponsors and fun projects to share today, so make sure to visit each stop along the way. At the top of the description box, you will find the link to the next person in the lineup. I hope you take the time to watch all the Hop videos because we love your comments and thumbs up. If you aren't already a subscriber, I hope you consider subscribing and click on the little bell so you won't miss any of my uploads. You can also use hashtag HonestAmpage2020 to find all of the videos in this hop in order to maximize your chances of winning one of our grand prizes. Some of us might be offering prizes on our channels, so be sure to pay attention for details. At the end of this hop, we will have a grand prize winners drawn from those who watched and commented on all Hop videos. The grand prize drawings are open internationally. Please check out my description box for all the details. And now, enjoy this video. So I'm going to start with the watercolor paper. I've cut it into 4.25 by 5.5 inches. And I have these four shades of brushes. I have scarlet, emerald green, black, and yellow. I'm going to use all four. What I'm going to do first is I will start with the scarlet and the black and yellow, and I'm going to take a dry brush and I'm just going to put a little bit of color on the sides of my paper, not much, just a little bit, because these crystals are extremely concentrated. Now I'll go with the red. And then a little bit of black at the bottom. And just make sure that I cover the lids. And put these away. And then I'm going to take a spray bottle and I'm going to spray down the side of the card. See what happens is you get this beautiful splattered effect. Now, bit of the crystals fell on the paper, so I'm not going to let that go to waste. I'll just keep this away to dry. And I have this little extra piece of paper which is left over. So what I will do is I will just spray that with water off camera. And then I'm just going to start catching all these colors with it. Okay, and I will set this aside to dry. Now I'll just wipe this off with a piece of cloth. I just love all the different colors which this has. Brushes is a pretty new medium for me. So I'm also learning as I'm doing this video. And I think I'm really enjoying the whole process, because these colors are really beautiful and really intense. Now I've dried the piece off camera and you can see the beautiful grungy kind of a pattern which you've got. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in the एमरल्ड ग्रीन ब्रश हो, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू पुट द ग्रीन हियर बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट इट एनीवेयर नियर वेयर द रेड इज, बिकॉज इफ रेड एंड ग्रीन मिक्स दे विल गिव मी अ ब्राउनिश कलर व्हिच आई डेफिनेटली डोंट वांट. सो आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट ब्रश सम ग्रीन ऑन दिस. At the edge, more at the edge. Then I will take the yellow again. Just wipe this bottle down. Away, and then finally I'll come in with the black again. And now let's repeat the process. I will take my spray bottle and just start spraying. I think there was a little bit too much of black, so what I'll do is I'll just wipe that away. I'll let this dry completely, and then we can make a nice card out of this. Okay, now let's proceed with the rest of the card. What I have here is two pieces of black paper that I have used these dies. This is the Bold Blooms die set by Aline Hudson. So I've used those for doing the partial die cutting. I'll just remove the die. And I've left a little space here to create a hinge. I've drawn the line, and now I'm just going to mark the spaces where I want the cutting to be, and then I'll turn this around and I will take my straight ruler and if there are any pieces which are still attached, you can just use your cutter to cut those things out. Okay, and we'll just remove the die cut pieces inside. If there are any pieces stuck like this one, don't force it out. You can just go with a cutter later on and remove it. Okay, now see, if you'll see, notice these are still stuck to the paper. So what I'm going to do is just take my craft knife and just carefully cut the paper away. Then you can just take a scissor or just use your knife to smoothen the edge. So this is what our piece will look when we put it on the card.
For the sentiment, I'm using the Hip Hip stamp set by Kaiser Craft.
I like the bold sentiments that the stamp set has, and I'm going to be using the second set of sentiments. Also, I'm going to do a bit of selective stamping with this. I already have a small scrap of black paper on my stamp positioner, and I'm going to just place the stamp on it and then close the lid. Now I'll use some plain talcum powder and an old makeup brush to make sure that there is no static on my paper. I'll just turn my stamp positioner so you'll be able to get a better look at the way I do the selective stamping. What I'm basically going to do is take a little strip of washi tape, and I'm going to position it over the stamp. So I'm basically masking part of the stamp. And now I'll just take my pad of Versamark ink and ink the stamp thoroughly. Once the inking is done, I will just peel off the washi tape. I just take a piece of scrap paper from a magazine, and I'm going to be using the metallic gold embossing powder by Ranger. So I will sprinkle that powder on the paper. Just tap the excess away. And then I will use a small paintbrush to brush away the embossing powder from any of the areas where I don't want it to stick. This happens a lot, especially with stamps which you use often. Some residual ink might transfer on your paper. So it is always handy to keep a paintbrush around and just brush flecks of the powder away. And now I will just take the piece off camera and do the heat embossing. And there, that is my part of my sentiment is done. The top part of it I have again stamped and covered with embossing powder, following the same steps. And my sentiment is ready. For assembling the card now, I have the background which I have trimmed to slightly smaller than A2 size. I have the two panels which I did partial die cutting with. And I have the heat embossed sentiment which I eventually ended up in cutting into three pieces. Now I'll take the piece in which I had left a little tab on the side, put some glue on it, and I will stick it to the background. This will create a nice little flap which can be opened when the card is complete. I like to use liquid glue in most of my work because I find that this glue is very strong, and it also gives me a little wiggle room so that I can shift things around because liquid glue takes a little longer to dry. So I'll make sure the piece lies exactly the way I want it. And I'll take the second piece and I will place it so that the flowers don't overlap. I didn't bother leaving a tab on the side for this piece because I knew that it was going to be slightly larger than what I needed. So now, once it is in place, I will just flip the paper over and I'll take a pencil and just draw a line. This is where I need a crease to be put. So I will do that off camera with my scoreboard. And there, I've scored the paper. Now all I have to do is put liquid glue on the tab and just stick it to the background. So those are the two flaps which cover the background. I didn't want to waste any of the background, and at the same time I wanted to have a little sort of an interactive action going. So this kind of a pop-up panel card just is perfect. Now I will just place the sentiments in such a way that the flaps cover them completely. and then just glue them down. There, now the sentiment is completely hidden by the flam. Now that large flower, I realized it was just sticking out. So I just added some glue to it and I stuck it down to the background directly so that it doesn't flap open. And now my card front is complete. I've put the final piece of the sentiment on it. I'll just let this dry a little bit. The final step is sticking the ready panel on a craft card base, which I've cut to A2 size. This I didn't pop it up on foam or anything because I didn't want to make the card too bulky. So I'm just going to put some liquid glue in the background. Behind the panel. And I will just stick it to the card base. And there, our card front is complete. So our card with a bold background and partial die cuts is ready. I just added a last detail later. I took a stamp set called Interactive Cards by Mudra, and which basically has a lot of messages which are meant for interactive cards. And I stamped the word flip on both the flaps so that the recipient knows to open it up when he or she receives it. I also added a little bit of repositionable adhesive at the corners of the flap so that they wouldn't keep opening all the time. So here, the whole card is ready. I hope you enjoyed this video and you will subscribe to my channel and keep coming back for more videos. I also encourage you to complete the hop because there are lots of very interesting videos on, and a lot of prizes are up for grabs. Some of the stops are also offering, some of the crafters are also offering their own prizes. So I encourage you to check it out. The links are there in the description below. And I hope to see you soon. Bye.